When a man truly cherishes you, he'll begin to share certain sentiments. Dive into this journey of understanding profound affection. Real love transcends the fleeting thrills of new romance, eclipsing the transient buzz of attraction. It's a deep-rooted bond marked by shared understanding, empathy, and a sense of security that strengthens over time. This kind of love transforms a couple into not just lovers, but into lifelong partners, trusted confidants, and steadfast supporters of one another. But how do you recognize when a man reaches this depth of love? Listen closely to the words he chooses to express his feelings. Specific phrases, when spoken with genuine intent, are unmistakable signs of deep love. Let's focus on a pivotal indicator, the transition from I to we. This change is more than a simple tweak in vocabulary. It's a testament to his emotional investment and commitment. As a man falls deeply in love, his dialogue about the future and his aspirations begins to include you. This isn't merely a change in speech. It reflects a shift in his perspective, revealing his readiness to intertwine his life with yours. This move from I to we signifies that he no longer views his path as solitary, but as a shared journey with you. It demonstrates his vision of a united partnership, poised to navigate the challenges and joys of life together. In crafting this message, we steer clear of modern jargon that might obscure the timeless essence of our message. We avoid phrases that might stray from the core values rooted in classical wisdom, ensuring our language resonates with a broad audience without leaning into concepts like postmodernism or reincarnation, which could divert from our grounded, universally relatable message. This dialogue isn't about preaching from a high horse. It's an invitation to witness the undeniable truths of deep, enduring love. We're not selling an idea. We're acknowledging the powerful reality of a love that's deeply woven into the fabric of our lives. 2. The power of expressing gratitude, for instance, becomes a beacon of his love for you. Imagine hearing the words, "I appreciate you," from him. Such a simple phrase, yet it's weighted with profound meaning. This isn't about the grand gestures or the milestones celebrated with pomp and fanfare. No, this is about the everyday magic, the subtle acts of kindness and care that often go unnoticed. In the tapestry of love, these words are threads of gold, highlighting the importance of the small, seemingly insignificant moments. He sees the early morning coffee you made when you were both rushed, the way you listened to him after a long day, even the smile you shared with a stranger. These moments, small as they may seem, are monumental to him because they are extensions of you. His acknowledgement of these gestures, both big and small, is a way of holding a mirror to your soul, showing you just how valuable you are. It's his way of saying, "I see you, all of you, and I cherish what I see." This constant appreciation is not about keeping score. It's about recognizing the essence of your being and the light you bring into his life. It signifies that he doesn't take your presence for granted. Every effort you make, every piece of yourself that you give, he treasures. This is a hallmark of a man deeply in love. He understands the significance of your role in his life, acknowledging every little thing you do that makes his world brighter. Let me be clear. When a man genuinely loves you, his gratitude transcends words. It becomes a testament to the depth of his feelings, a declaration that he values not just what you do, but who you are. This is a man who knows the importance of the journey you're on together, appreciating every step, every stumble, and every sprint. This recognition of the mundane as miraculous, of the ordinary as extraordinary, is what sets his love apart. It's a reminder that in the realm of true love, the smallest actions hold the greatest meanings. So, when he says, "I appreciate you," understand that what he's really saying is, "I value your essence, your being, and all the ways you enhance my life." This is the language of love in its purest form, a love that sees, a love that appreciates, a love that truly understands. 3. Trust and safety. Historically, societal norms have placed a heavy burden on men, urging them to don a mask of stoicism and emotional invulnerability. This unspoken rule dictated that true strength lay in silence and emotional fortitude. Yet, the essence of true love has the power to dismantle these barriers, creating a sanctuary of trust and safety. In the embrace of genuine affection, a man finds the courage to lay bare his soul, to traverse beyond the superficial, and delve into the depths of his emotional vulnerabilities. This openness is not limited to moments of fear or insecurity. It encompasses the full spectrum of human emotion. From the whispers of joy to the echoes of sadness, from the currents of love to the tremors of anxiety, every sentiment is shared with unguarded honesty. It's a testament to the strength of your bond, a declaration that in the sanctuary of your presence, he finds the freedom to be truly himself. In a world that often values bravado over vulnerability, this level of emotional honesty is a rare gift. It signifies a departure from the facades of strength imposed by societal expectations, inviting a connection that is rooted in authenticity and mutual understanding. So, when a man shares his fears, hopes, and his dreams, know that it's not just words being spoken, it's the language of the heart, a sign of true love, and an invitation to a journey of shared vulnerability and connection. 4 is a sign that signifies the depth of his feelings towards you. The moment he genuinely asks, "What's your take on this?" This question, simple on the surface, is a profound testament to the value he places on your thoughts and feelings. It's not just small talk. It's a revelation of his deep respect and admiration for you. When he faces decisions, big or small, he doesn't just go through the emotions of asking for your opinion. He seeks it because your perspective matters deeply to him, because in the tapestry of his life, your voice is a guiding thread. This gesture of involving you in his thought process is a beacon of true partnership. It's not merely about joint decision-making. It's about recognizing and honoring your insights as vital. This act elevates the relationship to a realm of mutual respect and equality, showcasing his genuine appreciation for who you are. When a man integrates your viewpoints into his life's choices, it's clear he's not just passing the time with you. He's building a foundation with you, brick by brick, where every brick is a token of respect for your intellect and heart. This dynamic of shared decision-making is a cornerstone of a deeply connected relationship. It reflects a bond that goes beyond the superficial, anchored in mutual admiration and respect. It's about him acknowledging your significance in his life, not just in moments of ease, but in every decision that shapes your journey together. In a world where authenticity and genuine connection are treasures, this practice of valuing your opinion is a clear signal of a love that's deep and real. It signifies a partnership where both individuals are seen, heard, and valued. So, when he asks for your viewpoint, know that it's more than a question. It's a testament to the depth of his feelings for you, a sign that in the vastness of his world, your voice, your thoughts, and your presence truly matter. This isn't about grand gestures or overt declarations. It's about the quiet, consistent respect shown through seeking your perspective, a sign of a love that's thoughtful, considerate, and profoundly connected. It's a reminder that in love, the most powerful connections are those built on the foundation of mutual respect and understanding. 5. The phrase, "I'm here for you, no matter what," carries the weight of an unwavering commitment, a testament to the depth of his love. This declaration is far from being mere words. It's an oath, a pledge of his steadfast support and unconditional love. It transcends the ordinary, highlighting a bond that's not shaken by the trials of life. Such a promise indicates that he's not just around for the sunny days, but also the stormy ones, ready to stand by you when the going gets tough. this commitment paints a picture of a future filled with togetherness, where challenges are faced hand in hand. It's about having a partner who's not just present in moments of joy, but also a pillar of strength in times of adversity. He's signaling a future where he is constant, a reliable presence in your life, someone who sees beyond the here and now, envisioning a lifetime of shared experiences and support. When a man vocalizes this level of dedication, it's a clear sign he values the relationship's longevity over fleeting moments. It shows he's in it for the long haul, prepared to navigate life's ups and downs together. This kind of assurance is what sets the foundation for a strong, enduring relationship. It's about creating a safe space where you feel cherished and supported, knowing you have someone who truly believes in the power of your union. 6. Let's talk about what keeps us both feeling secure and respected. This gesture stands as a testament to his commitment, not just to the relationship's surface level, but to its core, its heart and soul. It's about laying the foundations for a partnership grounded in mutual esteem and comprehension. When he steps forward to initiate these discussions, it's as if he's planting a flag of dedication in the ground, signaling his intent to cultivate a bond that thrives on mutual appreciation and care. He isn't just setting boundaries. He's inviting you into a space where both of your needs, hopes, and personal territories are acknowledged and honored. This act of reaching out to understand and accommodate each other's limits and desires is a demonstration of his investment in the health and future of your connection. It's about more than just avoiding discomfort. It's about creating a shared understanding that enriches your relationship. Imagine this is a journey you embark on together, where the goal is not just to mark territories, but to explore and appreciate the landscapes of each other's worlds. This endeavor requires a level of maturity and compassion that is essential for any meaningful and lasting relationship. By engaging in these heart-to-heart discussions, he shows that he's not only in this for the short haul, but is deeply invested in building a partnership that stands the test of time. This approach to boundaries and mutual respect is the bedrock upon which a healthy, loving relationship is built. It's a clear indication that he values you and the life you are building together. This isn't about restricting freedom. It's about understanding and embracing each other's uniqueness, ensuring that both partners feel seen, heard, and valued. So, when a man willingly navigates these conversations with you, it's a powerful sign of his love and respect. It demonstrates a readiness to build something lasting, grounded on the principles of mutual respect and understanding. It's a commitment to not just being lovers, but allies, partners who are in tune with each other's needs and boundaries. This dialogue is a crucial step towards creating a union where both individuals can flourish, feeling supported and cherished in equal measure.
Isaiah 46:4 says, "Even to your old age and gray hairs I am He. I am He who will sustain you. I have made you and I will carry you. I will sustain you and I will rescue you." You find yourself at that pivotal moment where every prayer uttered, every moment of waiting, culminates in the possibility standing right in front of you. A person who could potentially be the one you've been waiting for. But amidst the flutter of anticipation, there's a lingering question echoing in your mind. Is this it? Could he or she truly be the one? Here's the crux of it all. What's meant for you won't evade you if you refuse to let it go. There's a distinct someone out there, meticulously crafted to fit into the intricacies of your life. A divine design set in motion just for you. And here's the kicker. They won't play games with your heart. Doubts and uncertainties need not apply here. Believe it or not, you're not alone in this journey. God's got a plan, a partner specifically tailored for you, waiting to embark on this journey alongside you. Consider this. Out of the vastness of creation, humans are the chosen conduits for divine purpose. So when it comes to matters as profound as love, trust that it's well within human jurisdiction. Someone, somewhere, is being meticulously fashioned to complement your existence, to fulfill the longings of your heart. And when this destined individual enters your life, they won't just meander through obstacles. They'll confront and conquer every barrier in their path to reach you. Why? Because they're propelled by a higher calling, a calling ordained by the divine. And when the Almighty issues a decree to the one fashioned for you, rest assured it will be fulfilled. Prepare yourself for the extraordinary, for when divine intervention is at play, the ordinary constraints of life fall by the wayside. This isn't wishful thinking, it's the unfolding of a divine promise, the promise you've held on to through prayers and hopes. Your love story isn't subject to the limitations of this world. It's scripted by the hand of a higher power. So take heart, hold on to your faith, and witness as the tapestry of your life intertwines seamlessly with the plans of the divine matchmaker. In the tapestry of life, where every thread is meticulously woven, your story finds its place, intricately connected to a larger design crafted by the divine. So lean into the journey, embrace the uncertainties, and trust what's meant for you will always find its way to you. You're the one they've been searching for, because they're the one for you too. Genuine love and positive energy gravitate towards authenticity. It's a reciprocal exchange. Good attracts good. One surefire sign that the person meant for you will consistently pursue you is that you also resonate with them on a deep level. You've cultivated genuine emotions and aligned yourself with the right person, which inevitably draws them closer to you. Recognize the significance of maintaining your standards while trusting in a higher power to guide you to the right individual. Take heed and avoid missteps. If you desire a quality partner in your life, you must also embody those qualities. You can't expect someone to fulfill your expectations if you're not willing to do the same for them. Divine intervention operates on this principle. If you're seeking the best, you must strive to become the best version of yourself. When you've fully committed to this journey with the guidance of a higher power, you'll have the assurance that the right person will pursue you relentlessly, regardless of circumstances. You're both meant to be together, and divine orchestration ensures that nothing disrupts that union. When God orchestrates a connection, nothing can thwart it. You surrendered your heart to a higher purpose, knowing that the divine plan always leads to something good. Trust in the unwavering faithfulness of God's promises. His word guarantees that the person destined for you will never slip away. They'll always seek you out, recognizing that you're the one meant for them. And when that moment arrives, God will align your spirits in perfect harmony, much like the bond between Jonathan and David. Their souls intertwined, as if they'd known each other for years. Similarly, the person meant for you has been spiritually acquainted with you for ages. Your connection has been long established in the realm beyond our physical existence. And when it comes to knowing if someone's truly the one for you, there's one crucial aspect that outweighs all others: God's confirmation. Let me make this clear. If God indicates that someone isn't meant for you, then they're not, period. No amount of other signs or indicators can override that divine directive. Now, here's the flip side. Even if God confirms that someone is indeed the one for you, it doesn't necessarily mean it's time to dive headfirst into a relationship. Timing matters. If other signs suggest that this person isn't ready or circumstances aren't right, then it might not be the opportune moment. Marriage isn't a trivial decision. It's second only to the choice to follow Jesus. And believe me, God cares deeply about who you marry. He doesn't want you to end up with the wrong person. So when you're seeking confirmation from God about a potential partner, rest assured that He will speak to you and guide you along the right path. As Psalm 32:8 tells us, the Lord says, "I will guide you along the best pathway for your life. I will advise you and watch over you." God's guidance may come in various forms. It could be a dream, a vision, or even a message relayed through a friend. The key is to stay attuned to the Holy Spirit, because that's how God communicates His will to us. Don't expect flashy signs or neon lights pointing you in the right direction. Instead, listen to that inner voice, that sense of knowing deep within your spirit. That's how God will confirm that this person's the one He's chosen for you. Let me share a personal example. My wife received confirmation from God through dreams and fulfilled prophecies that I was the one for her. It was a profound and unmistakable confirmation of God's will. Moving on to another crucial indicator, peace. When you're in a relationship that's aligned with God's plan, you'll feel a sense of peace that transcends understanding. As Colossians 3:15 says, "Let the peace that comes from Christ rule in your hearts." If both you and your partner experience this peace, it's a strong indication that you're meant to be together. However, if something feels off despite all the positive qualities, don't ignore it. Dive deep into prayer and seek clarity from God. Lack of peace could be a sign that either this person isn't the one for you, or it's simply not the right time to pursue a relationship. Remember, God's confirmation and inner peace are your compass in matters of the heart. Trust in His guidance, and He will lead you to the one He's prepared for you. You see, a man who truly loves God, who walks in alignment with His will, is the kind of man you should truly be seeking. It's not merely about surface-level qualities or fleeting gestures. It's about a foundational commitment to God. Imagine this, a man who embodies love in its truest sense, a man who not only professes faith, but lives it out daily. This is the kind of man who understands the significance of being equally yoked, of sharing spiritual connection that transcends mere attendance at religious gatherings. He's not just a companion on Sundays. He's a partner in your spiritual journey, someone who uplifts and supports your relationship with God. Now, picture this scenario. You're in a relationship where your faith is not just respected, but cherished, where spiritual growth is a shared endeavor. That's the kind of partnership that brings fulfillment and joy, one where both individuals are aligned in their devotion to God. But beware of those who merely pay lip service to faith, those who lack the depth of commitment required for a truly God-centered relationship. Indeed, a man who loves you as Christ loved the church is a rare gem, a reflection of divine love in human form. His love is not merely words, but sacrificial actions, a willingness to lay down His life for your well-being. This is the standard set by God Himself, a love that transcends earthly expectations and mirrors the profound love of Christ. So, as you navigate the journey of love and faith, remember this: the one meant for you will pursue and adore you, not just with earthly affection, but with a love rooted in the divine. Seek a partner who not only shares this faith, but lives it out in every aspect of life. For in the union of two souls dedicated to God, there lies the truest fulfillment and the deepest joy. There's someone who needs to hear these words. Perhaps you, who's been tirelessly seeking confirmation from the Lord about your relationship. You might find yourself in prayer, earnestly asking God, "Is this the individual you've destined for me?" Your heart is open, filled with hope and faith that the answer will affirm your deepest desires. Yet it seems as if silence is the only response from above. Let's reflect on a pivotal moment in the Bible for guidance. Consider the time when Jesus, fully aware of the sacrifice He was about to make for humanity's salvation, retreated to the Garden of Gethsemane. There, He humbly placed His fears before God, saying, as recorded in Matthew 26:39, "Father, if it is possible, let this cup pass from me. Nevertheless, not as I will, but as you will." This moment is profound, not because Jesus received a direct reply from God, but because He demonstrated unwavering trust in God's plan, despite the lack of a clear answer. You might feel that God has remained silent regarding your questions about your relationship. Yet it's crucial to understand that sometimes God's silence, or the lack of a clear sign, is in itself a guiding message. Jesus didn't receive an audible answer to His plea, but the unfolding events around Him provided the clarity He needed. Similarly, your current circumstances may be revealing God's will regarding your relationship. If you find yourself questioning, unsure, or in a situation that seems to bring more doubt than peace, these could be indicators guiding you towards what's truly meant for you. God has a remarkable plan for each of us, including who we walk our earthly journey with. If the path with someone seems fraught with uncertainty or discord, It might be a divine nudge steering you towards something better, something more aligned with God's perfect plan for your life. How then do our situations speak to us? Well, they do so by aligning or contrasting with the peace and clarity that comes from being in God's will. In your heart, if turmoil rather than tranquility prevails when thinking of your current relationship, take a moment to reflect. This discomfort might very well be the way God is communicating His intentions for you. It's not through grand gestures or booming voices from heavens, but through the very essence of our daily experiences and internal peace, or the lack thereof. So I urge you, listen not only for a voice, but also for the message woven through the fabric of your life. God's guidance often manifests in the quietude of our hearts and the unfolding of our circumstances. Trust in His timing and plan, for He desires nothing but the best for His children. Your journey towards love and companionship is sacred, and when guided by divine wisdom, it'll lead you to the fulfillment of His perfect design for your life. Remember, this dialogue is not just about seeking the one, but understanding that God's plans for us are comprehensive, encompassing every aspect of our lives, including our romantic relationships. Let us walk in faith, open to the signs He provides, ready to embrace His will with open hearts. It's essential to recognize the signs that may indicate a relationship isn't aligned with God's best for you. At times, the person we're drawn to may inadvertently lead us away from the peace that should hallmark a godly partnership. If you're finding yourself in a place of confusion, where the stability of their affection or commitment seems uncertain, manifested through inconsistent communication or actions that don't foster trust, it's a moment to pause and reflect. A relationship that diverts you from your faith, encouraging actions that contradict God's teachings, such as premarital sexual relations, is a clear sign that this may not be the divine match for you. Love, in its truest God-given form, seeks to protect and uplift, not lead into temptation or sin. It's a relationship that brings you closer to God, not one that creates a chasm between you and your faith. It's possible to share a faith, yet still find yourselves spiritually mismatched. This misalignment could stem from differences in theological beliefs, spiritual maturity, or dedication to living out one's faith. Even within the Christian community, it's crucial to find someone who resonates with your spiritual journey and convictions. True companionship in marriage is rooted in unity, not just in shared labels, but in shared lives, beliefs, and directions. God's vision for your life includes companionship that is enriching, edifying, and in harmony with His purpose for you. The Creator, who orchestrated the unions of Adam and Eve, Isaac and Rebekah, understands the desires of your heart more profoundly than you might yourself. He knows what you need in a partner to fulfill your divine calling together. Reflecting on personal experiences, I've learned that not every relationship that seems right or fervently desired aligns with God's plan. There was a time when I was convinced about a certain individual, despite clear indications that we were not spiritually compatible. Differences in our understanding and expression of faith revealed a deeper disconnection. It's a poignant reminder that our hearts can sometimes mislead us, swayed by emotions or desires that don't reflect God's best for us. In my journey, I discovered that the absence of dramatic signs does not signify a lack of divine approval. With my now spouse, the relationship was characterized by a profound peace and mutual theological and spiritual alignment. Our connection wasn't heralded by grand gestures, but by a quiet certainty and shared values. Even enjoying simple pleasures like listening to our favorite soundtracks. This peace and alignment were my true signs, underscoring that a relationship ordained by God isn't necessarily marked by fireworks, but by a deep-seated harmony and shared life path. Finding the one isn't about relentless searching for signs, but understanding and feeling peace in God's presence within the relationship. It's about mutual growth, respect, and a partnership that draws you closer to Him. As we navigate the complexities of relationships, let's seek His guidance and trust in His timing, knowing He has our best interests at heart. in the plan that surpasses our own. In the journey of finding a companion, it's crucial to understand that while the allure of a trophy spouse may seem enticing, the essence of a relationship goes far beyond superficial accolades. The fundamental truth is, God's vision of a relationship transcends the labels of boyfriend and girlfriend, anchoring instead in the sacred bond of covenant. This covenant is not just a mere contract. It's a divine promise where God's blessings flow abundantly, empowering the couple to make significant impacts in the spiritual realm. The scripture emphasizes the strength found in unity, particularly with the context of marriage. Jesus' instruction to his disciples to pair up, and his assurance that where two or more are gathered in his name, he is present, underscores the transformative power of united prayer and purpose. Marriage, then, is not just a union of hearts, but a formidable force against the adversaries and spiritual warfare we face. Within the sanctity of marriage, prayers become more potent, and the intimate bond of sex transcends physical pleasure, becoming a sacred act that solidifies the covenant further. However, aligning with someone who diverges from your spiritual path can have detrimental effects, as illustrated by the biblical tale of Samson and Delilah. Samson, though anointed by God with extraordinary strength, saw his downfall through Delilah, who exploited his love for her to uncover the secret of his strength, ultimately leading to his tragic demise. This narrative serves as a sobering reminder that our emotional attachments, when not aligned with God's wisdom, can lead us away from our divine purpose. Reflecting on personal experiences, the gratitude for divine intervention becomes palpable when considering relationships that were not meant to be. The stark contrast between a relationship that could have stifled one's spiritual growth and one that flourishes under God's approval is evident. My own journey led me to my wife, Dawn, a woman whose spiritual and personal attributes deeply resonate with my own. Together, we embody the principle that partners in marriage should not only love, but also elevate each other's calling and purpose. If I had pursued a path with someone not aligned with my spiritual calling, the disharmony could have hindered both our purposes. Instead, being united with someone who fits like a glove enhances our ability to serve and fulfill our God-given missions. This synergy within a marriage does not just benefit the couple, but extends to their community and the broader kingdom of God. Marriage, therefore, is not a mere earthly contract, but a heavenly covenant that holds the power to transform lives, influence communities, and combat spiritual darkness. It's a union that should complement and amplify the divine calling on each person's life. As such, it's paramount to seek God's guidance in finding a partner who not only shares your love, but also your commitment to faith and purpose. This divine selection process ensures that the union will not only survive, but thrive, making a lasting impact on the world for the glory of God. Finding a life partner is one of deep spiritual significance. It requires discernment, prayer, and a steadfast trust in God's plan for our lives. By aligning our hearts with His will, we open doors to a relationship that transcends physical attraction and emotional satisfaction, entering into a covenant blessed by God, capable of withstanding the trials of this world, and contributing to the expansion of His kingdom.
Have you ever stopped to wonder why some people seem to have this amazing connection that feels almost magical? Well, I believe it's because God has a hand in it. You might be wondering if God really plays matchmaker. Well, yes, He does. He's pretty happy when He sees two people who are meant to be together come together. It's really tough when you invest your heart in someone only to find out it's not a good fit. But when God brings someone into your life, it's not a coincidence. He has a plan for that relationship. That's why it feels like there's something special, something bigger connecting you two. He puts you together because He knows that person is your safe harbor, someone who will bring you comfort and support in life's ups and downs. Dear friend, if God brings you together with someone, it's because He knows it's for the best and will lead you to a fulfilling outcome. Why? Because He's the one laying the groundwork for the relationship. And when God is at the center of any relationship, you can be sure His plans are solid. There are signs that God is founding a relationship between you and someone. These signs are clues to God's plan and purpose for you. Watch this video all the way through, and don't forget to like and share. As we dive into today's topic, let's explore some of the signs that God uses to bring people together. Expect amazing things to happen in your life through God's miraculous work today. Number 1. Genuine love. Pay attention, because if God wants you to be with someone, there will be a deep, genuine affection between the two of you. It's not just surface-level attraction, it's a true, heartfelt love that comes from a genuine connection between two hearts. This kind of love isn't something that just happens naturally. It's orchestrated by God Himself. You'll notice that you're constantly drawn closer to each other. Do you ever wonder why you feel such deep, intimate affection for that person? The special love you share will make you feel at ease whenever you're together. These feelings are put in place by God because it honors Him when hearts are united. After all, God is love, and we're expected to love as He does. 1 Peter 2:9 says, "But you are a chosen people, a royal priesthood, a holy nation, God's special possession, that you may declare the praises of Him who called you out of darkness into His wonderful light." God loves and cares for us, so He wants us to build our relationships based on His promises and principles. Following His guidance helps ensure that our relationships are built on a solid foundation, one that can't be shaken by the devil and his schemes. Number 2. Shared purpose. When God brings your hearts together, it's not by accident. There's a purpose behind it. If you find yourself deeply desiring to seek God together with your partner and serve Him wholeheartedly, it's a sign that God wants you to be with that person. When God is opening a relationship between you and someone, your spiritual hunger draws you closer, and talking about God and His plans feels natural and sincere. Remember that Matthew 6:33 says, "But seek first His kingdom and His righteousness, and all these things will be given to you as well." When you both share a commitment to doing God's will and following His purpose together, you can be sure that God is at the center of your relationship. This deepens your bond and companionship. You'll be amazed to see how everything falls into place for both of you, leading to a strong, fulfilling relationship that could eventually lead to marriage. Can you imagine trying to go about God's revealed purposes for your life, obeying His calling, attending services, and then struggling with a partner who doesn't want you to follow God, and certainly doesn't want to follow God themselves? I often tell people that in trusting God for a working relationship, you must also ask that God will deliver you from the battle of dragging an unwilling partner along. The journey becomes easier when you do it with a supportive partner who shares your purpose and vision. Number 3. Unexplainable peace and joy. Have you ever felt an unexplainable sense of peace and joy when you're with your partner? It's like God is whispering to you, "This is the one," when you're with them. There's no need to worry or feel alone, because they are like a shield protecting you from life's storms and a warrior ready to stand by your side in times of trouble. The comfort and peace you experience are gifts from God Himself, confirming that you're with the right person. While some people find themselves in relationships filled with pain and confusion, our God is faithful. He wouldn't give us someone who would hurt us or bring disaster into our lives. Instead, He blesses us with someone who will shape our lives and destinies according to His plan. This person will bring peace and joy. So when you feel that unexplainable joy, know that it's God bringing your hearts together. Number 4. Foundation of respect and trust. It's easy to fall in love and envision a future together, but the real questions are, do you truly love this person? Do you both trust and respect each other's decisions and opinions in the relationship? Any relationship built on an unstable foundation is bound to crumble. As the songwriter once penned, "On Christ the solid rock I stand, all other ground is sinking sand." When God is the cornerstone of your relationship, you can trust that it will be fulfilling. When God brings two people together, He creates a space for mutual understanding, respect, open communication, and trust. You will both honor each other's boundaries, listen to each other's perspectives, and value each other's ideas, regardless of the circumstances. Because of the love you share, you respond to each other's affection by trusting and respecting each other's opinions and values. My dear friend, just as God showers His love and care upon us, He also desires that we experience love and companionship. He sends us the one He has chosen for us, someone with whom we can have a fulfilling marriage. And one way to know that God has confirmed this person for you is through mutual feelings of love. When you express your feelings to this person, you'll notice that they're returned with warmth, love, affection, trust, and understanding. 1 Corinthians 13, 4-7 beautifully describes what love is. Love is patient. Love is kind. It does not envy. It does not boast. It is not proud. It does not dishonor others. It is not self-seeking. It is not easily angered. It keeps no record of wrongs. Love does not delight in evil, but rejoices with the truth. It always protects, always trusts, always hopes, always preserves. So when you find this kind of love in your relationship, know that it's God's confirmation that you found the one He has ordained for you. In conclusion, dear friend, our God is truly the ultimate matchmaker. If He brings someone into your life, you can trust that it's for the best. I encourage you to embrace this journey of being with the right person. As you walk alongside God in this relationship, believe in His mighty work. James 4:8 reminds us to draw near to God. "Come near to God, and He will come near to you. Wash your hands, you sinners, and purify your hearts, you double-minded." Remember, God is always close to us, but our sins can create distance. He loves us and wants us to draw near to Him so He can enrich our lives. Understand that God opens the door to a relationship with someone for a divine purpose, fate, and alignment. It's not a coincidence. This person is meant to be in your life, whether for growth, companionship, love, or support on your journey. Trust in God's plan and let Him lead you forward. Sometimes the relationship you're in might not turn out the way you imagined, but God works in mysterious ways. Just let Him unravel the secrets behind your relationship like a delicate flower blossoming in the sunlight. Your relationship will gradually become beautiful. Trust God and expect the best from Him as you journey together in this relationship. Seek the guidance of the Holy Spirit and pray for God's wisdom to help you be patient and understanding. This way, your relationship will be firmly rooted in God and His purposes. Remember, God's plans are bigger than ours. Even if the road to this relationship seems uncertain, know that God is faithful. He'll never leave you or stop loving you. Trust in His love throughout your life. My dear friend, remember, this relationship isn't just about two individuals coming together. It's about God crafting a connection filled with love, kindness, and purpose. May your journey in this relationship be blessed, and may this newfound love serve as a testament to God's goodness in your life and that of your partner.
When it comes to matters of love, it's important to keep in mind that every challenge and experience that you encounter on your journey is an opportunity to grow and improve your love life or marital life. Therefore, it's crucial to appreciate every moment and experience, both good and bad, as they all have a purpose according to God's will for you. In times of sudden change in your relationship, it's essential to understand that it's all part of God's divine guidance for you to have a fulfilling and satisfying life. As stated in Ecclesiastes 3:1, there's a time for everything, and every season has its purpose. If you're experiencing a difficult or confusing moment in your relationship, know that there are special reasons for it, and God has a plan for you. Look for signs that He wants you to be with that person, and trust that He's with you every step of the way. Like I pointed out earlier, and like we always try to tell you in our videos, when God brings someone into your life, there's always a purpose behind it. It's up to you to be open and receptive to His guidance, and to trust the process. Although it's natural to feel anxious and uncertain about the future, especially when it comes to matters of the heart, remember that there is no fear in love, especially when it's coming from the one who created it. God is good at companionship and matchmaking, and if He's interested in your relationship, it's for the best. Trust His plan, and believe that He'll make everything perfect in the end. In relationships, we often encounter various challenges and complications. However, it's crucial to seek God's guidance, especially for a fulfilling home and marriage. Now, let me show you some signs that may indicate God's intention for you to end up with the person you're currently in a relationship with. I encourage you to watch this video till the end. Subscribe, like, share, and trust God for a positive transformation in your relationship. Alright, now let's dive deeper. If your current relationship is hindering your progress in life, it might be a sign from God to end that relationship. Some people find themselves in a situation where the relationship doesn't seem to be moving beyond just dating. Perhaps you notice the other person hesitates to take the relationship to the next level. This clear sign indicates God may not want you to be with that person, as your hearts aren't aligned. Mark 10:6-8 says, "But at the beginning of creation, God made them male and female. For this reason, a man will leave his father and mother and be united to his wife, and the two will become one flesh, so they are no longer two, but one flesh." This biblical perspective emphasizes the unity and oneness that should characterize a God-centered relationship. When you find yourself in a relationship where your partner's values and beliefs align with yours, and both of you strive for progress in every aspect of your shared life, understand that God is actively involved in your relationship. Even though challenges may arise, God assures you that as long as your hearts are united, there's no need to fear. Doubts and trials may emerge, but be encouraged. These are moments that lead to fulfillment. Dear Saint, if fear begins to seep into your relationship, don't hastily abandon it. As long as love exists between you and your partner, things will work out. 1 Corinthians 13, 4-7 tells us, "Love is patient, love is kind, it does not envy, it does not boast, it is not proud, it does not dishonor others, it is not self-seeking, it is not easily angered, and it keeps no record of wrongs. Love does not delight in evil, but rejoices with the truth. It always protects, always trusts, always hopes, always perseveres." God encourages you to hold on to that person because your destiny is intertwined with theirs. Do not let doubt or fear be a barrier. That fear is a sign that God wants both of you together, serving as a stepping stone for you to ascend to the next phase in life. Trust in His guidance and continue to build a strong foundation based on love and shared values. The journey of love can often feel like an arduous and uncertain path, much like the biblical story of the children of Israel spying on the land of Canaan. Despite God's promise of a land flowing with milk and honey, the Israelites were filled with doubt and fear as they journeyed. They were afraid that the people they encountered along the way were giants, and that they themselves were not strong enough to conquer the land. However, they had no idea that beyond that fear lay great promises and divine plans. In the same way, you may have been hurt in the past due to a failed relationship, making it difficult for you to trust or allow anyone into your life. You may even feel like you'll never find love again. But the truth is, you can find love again, and you can trust in God's plans for your life. He is the ultimate companion and takes great joy in seeing two people who are meant to be together fall in love. Proverbs 18:22 says, "He who finds a wife finds what is good and receives favor from the Lord." This verse speaks to the beauty and importance of finding the right person to share your life with. Fear can be so overwhelming that it can cause you to doubt God's promises and question whether you'll ever find the right person. But always remember that God's promise is that you can overcome fear as long as you're with the right person. So trust in Him and be open to the beauty and possibilities that love can bring. In any relationship, it's important to appreciate the uniqueness of your partner and cherish the love that you both share. When times get tough and fear and doubt start to weigh you down, it's crucial to hold on to the love that you have for each other. The more you allow love for your partner to dwell in your heart, the more you'll break free from the fear. Ephesians 4:31-32 provides a valuable reminder for us all. Get rid of all bitterness, rage and anger, brawling and slander, along with every form of malice. Be kind and compassionate to one another, forgiving each other, just as in Christ God forgave you. These words encourage us to let go of negative emotions and instead show kindness, compassion, and forgiveness to one another. When fear leaves, you open the doors of joy within yourself, and this helps you to trust and love your partner even more. It's important to believe in God's guidance because His ways of telling you to be with that person are often revealed through the strengthening of your bond and love. I want to let you know that God is using this video to uplift and heal you from the brokenness and fear of being in a relationship. You're not alone, and God is always with you. He will never leave you or forsake you because you are His child. And just as He says, you are a peculiar and special being, created by Him to show His praise. Your companionship glorifies God, and He's always working to help you build a strong and joyful relationship with your partner. As human beings, we all crave healthy and fulfilling relationships, and it's no different for those who believe in God. It's said that when God desires us to be with someone, He puts all the necessary means in place for that person to stick with us and shower us with love. This means that when we notice someone's drawn to us and we feel the same way towards them, it's likely that God wants us to be with them. However, it's important to note that love is not just about spoken words, but also about actions. We need to show our partner that we love them by being there for them, spending quality time with them, and supporting them in their endeavors. When we feel the need to draw closer to our partners and can't stay away from them, it's a clear indication that God wants us to be with them. It's important to remember that relationships are not always smooth sailing. There will be challenges and difficulties along the way, but these are all a part of God's plan to take us higher and strengthen our bond and love. We must appreciate and understand this divine guidance and trust that God will help us to make the right choices to have a fulfilling life. Love is a gift from God, and it's His love that can help us triumph in any relationship we find ourselves in. We need to love the person and trust that the person will reciprocate it. We should not be afraid that the relationship won't work out, because if it's meant to be, God will guide us through it. In conclusion, we should always remember that things happen for a reason, and any difficulty we face in a relationship is temporary and intended to take us into fulfilling God's purpose for our lives. As the scripture says in Romans 5:5, and hope does not put us to shame, because God's love has been poured out into our hearts through the Holy Spirit who has been given to us. With God's guidance, we can have a fulfilling life and enjoy the beauty of love in relationships.